Well, good evening. After my video last week, someone asked me, what got me started in taking video back then in 1990. And it's just, I've liked photography since I was a little kid. And for me, video is an extension of photography. I'd always wanted to take, very first camera is 12 exposures in a roll, and then once I started taking pictures with 35mm or 36, but I always wished I could just take as many pictures as I wanted, and then suddenly with video, that seemed to be what I had in my hands, to kind of take as much as you like machine, 30 frames per second, and with sound. And the other element of that is I believe that reality is much more interesting than fiction. And so if you can go out there, if you have a machine that records reality, and reality keeps changing, it just seems like it's important to record life, because it changes. And so that's, but I'd be walking along the street back then, taking a, I remember one time in particular, for some reason, I was walking over a pedestrian overpass in the evening, and some office workers were headed to the station. And as I walked past, they didn't, say anything. But as soon as they passed me, it was two guys in particular, I remember that one was saying, why is he recording this area? And there was no special reason I was recording that area, but it was a part of Tokyo, and then just, I remember the atmosphere of it in the evening with people heading home, and seemed kind of magical to me. It's I don't think I could quite capture that in the video, but at the time it's definitely seemed like a good thing to record if you could. Much more interesting than any tourist spot. I mean, tourist spots have their place, especially if they're historically relevant. It's important to preserve that sort of thing, and I guess that's a good thing for tourists to be able to see that sort of thing. But generally, I don't like tourist spots very much. I'm much more interested in all the elements of daily life. There's so much. I mean, the things that you're used to seeing, people just don't think about. But if you stop and think about it, a lot of things that are just there every day are really interesting, and they might not be there, next week, next month, next year, tomorrow. So, I think it's important to record life, especially since life is more interesting than fiction, I think. So that's basically it. Just, I guess also, someone else asked me before how I picked areas. It's just, I would go to places I'd never been to before, and then walk away from the station. There would usually be a bookstore in front of the station. I'd go there and buy a paper map. This is before smartphones and satellite navigation. So I'd buy a paper map, and I'd set out walking, and the map was basically so I wouldn't get lost, really. I wasn't so much looking at the map as deciding where to go. I wanted the map when I got away from the station so I could get back. And at least one, in some cases, if there's a river, sometimes the map would guide me where I was going a little bit. Mostly I just wanted to know where I was so I could, not get lost. But no, I'm rambling. But anyway, people often ask me why I started taking video back then. There was no YouTube. What was I planning to do with the material? I didn't know exactly. I just thought that, I could see that a lot of elements of Tokyo were disappearing on a day-by-day basis. And I thought it was important to record them. I didn't know exactly how I could make use of that material, but I believed that it was worth recording and that something could be done with the material in the future. And YouTube came along, so. All right. Yeah, I was gonna talk about the time machine. Maybe I'll skip that. Anyway, see ya.